Hello guys, this is Castoni. I wanted to make a different video from all my other videos, and in this video I would like to talk about top 5 greatest chess players of all time. So I'll give my top 5 list and I will try to give some decent facts and arguments why I picked them, not the others. So I made some investigation about this list, and yeah, we will see if you agree with me, maybe you don't. Let me know in the comments. Yeah, so 5th greatest chess players of all time in my opinion, it's great world champion José Raúl Capablanca. A child prodigy, probably the most naturally talented player of all time. And actually I have heard an interesting story about him from my coach like 10 years ago. So Capablanca was only 3 years old and his father was a good, let's say, amateur player. And his father was playing with his friend at his home. And after his dad lost a game, Capablanca suggested an improvement in the position, and his dad simply laughed and was shocked because he never taught his child how to play. And he felt insulted, so he offered to play a chess game with his son. And his son simply destroyed him. He was never taught the game of chess. He learned the game only by observing, and he simply crushed a good amateur player, his father. So, of course, we can't know for the fact that this is a true story, but there are a lot of stories about him like that. So some of them, of course, are lie and some of them are true. But if at least some of them are true, then this is simply a genius chess player. And he has to be at the mountain rush of the greatest chess players of all time. He was world champion for 6 years, but some of that was because of World War I, which prevented him from challenging for the title. And when he finally met reigning world champion Emmanuel Lasker in 1921, he convincingly won the match without losing a single game. It was something which was not seen for another 80 years, and he was only defeated for 34 times in his whole adult career, and only 27 people ever defeated Capa in a game of serious chess. And 9 of those players defeated him when he was, let's say, at his old age for him, because chess players, when they are 50 or higher, especially 100 years ago, he was considered to be old. And he had an incredible streak of 8 years without losing a single game. And this fact is just mind-boggling for me. I can't believe how you just don't lose a single chess game in 8 years. Come on. I mean, this is absurd. This is one of the probably the most ridiculous fact that I have heard about a chess player. 8 years without losing a game? I mean, come on, right? So, yeah. And he was known for not learning opening theory, but he was a genius in endgame. Probably one of the best endgame players of all time. And he especially known how to play good in composition. So he was like Karpov or Magnus style, if we compare him to newer era. Let's go to the 4th, Magnus Carlsen. I know, guys, you say, why, he's too young, but please hear my arguments. So he's the 3rd youngest grandmaster in chess history. When he was 13 years old, he drew a game against Garry Kasparov in a rapid game, and he won a game against Anatoly Karpov. On 2014 May, he reached his peak rating of 2882, which is the highest rating in the history of chess. He successfully defended his title at the same year, again defeating Danand. And at the same year, he won the World Rapid Championship and World Blitz Championship. So he was a pretty badass. He had classical World Championship title, Rapid and Blitz. So he was kicking everyone's ass at that time. And it just sounds crazy. When he was a teenager, he had very aggressive chess style, but he had struggles and problems to playing against top chess players at that time. So he developed a new and a successful universal style when he was capable of handling all sorts of positions very well. And Carlsen is known to win dravish endgames against top world grandmasters, and it happened a lot of times. Plus, there is no question that he is dominating the chess scene right now. And as you all know, chess is improving as the game. For example, we didn't have so many grandmasters 20 or 10 years ago, and the quality of chess is of course high right now. And he has a very, very huge competition right now. I can mention like and throw there the 20 great grandmasters, but he's simply the best among them, and he is just dominating the scene of chess. And I believe that he already is on the list of greatest chess players of all time. Third, Karpov. So he was world champion from 1975 to 1985, and it was an interesting story and kind of a sad story, because we didn't see a great match how he got the title. So Karpov agreed to all Fischer's conditions, and he wanted to play him very badly, but FIDE just didn't allow that, and Fischer had to pass the crown to Karpov. And determined to prove himself a legitimate champion, Karpov participated in nearly every major tournament for the next 10 years. He created a phenomenal streak of tournament wins against the strongest players in the world. He defended his title against probably the strongest player to never win the championship, Korchnoi. And he was known for amazing positional chess. He was more like a Magnus Carlsen type player or Capablanca, and then Fischer, Kasparov. He had 90 total months of number one and it's a second to none, but only Garry Kasparov. So it was a record till Kasparov broke it, and he won Chess Oscar for 9 times. Now I remember I asked my father about who he thinks is the greatest chess player of all time, and at 1970s, 1980s, he was a strong natural master, so he was kicking some master asses, but he was not a master. And he said Anatoly Karpov, and I told him why. I mean, he lost to Kasparov, and in his opinion, Karpov just wasn't at his peak when he was playing against Kasparov, and he thought that in 1975, 1980s, Karpov just was at his peak. But most of the chess players don't agree to that opinion, because when Anatoly Karpov played against Kasparov, they pushed each of them to their limits. And I think that at like 1995, 1990s, Karpov and Kasparov were at their peaks. But just it's just a lot of opinions about those two. Okay, number two, Bobby Fischer. So by many consider it to be the greatest chess player of all time at his peak. At the age of 20, Fischer won US championship with score 11 out of 11, so a perfect score, and it was the only perfect score in the history of US championship. And that championship included 6-time champion Ryshevsky, defending champion Piskuer, and a William Lombardi, who was junior championship at that year. Mathematics estimated his rating at his peak, and it was 28.93 in 1971. So that would have been the highest rating of all time. When Fischer went to play at the Candidates, Tal predicted that Fischer would win 5.5 against 4.5 against Taimanov, who was one of the greatest players at that time. And Fischer beat him 6-0. Who would have imagined that any challengers match would have been decided by a perfect score, when the participants are all to be ranked amongst the strongest players in the world, right? And Taimanov later recalled, I quote, when grandmasters play, they see the logic of their opponent's moves. One move may be so powerful that the other may not be able to stop him, but the plan behind the moves will be clear. Not so with Fischer. His moves that just didn't make any sense. And as a result of his performance, Taimanov was thrown out of the USSR team and forbidden to travel for 2 years. So Russians were pretty mad at him. And Fischer was next scheduled to play against Danish grandmaster Bent Larsen, who was also one of the greatest chess players at that time. And at that time, world champion Spassky predicted a tight struggle, and Fischer beat him 6-0. And later he won title against Boris Spassky after losing controversial first two games but making a huge comeback. And it's amazing how in a country where chess was not popular at all, such a talent and world champion was born. It was Cold War at the time, and it was a huge war on the chessboard. It wasn't just a fight between two players, it was a fight between two worlds. So The only sad thing is that we didn't see more of Bobby Fischer. He was dominating the chess scene for 5 years, and his match against Karpov maybe would have been greatest chess match of all time. So it's kind of sad, and many players believe that we don't know how good he was until he played against Karpov or Kasparov. So as you all probably predicted by now, top one and the greatest chess player of all time, in my opinion, Garry Kasparov. He was chess champion for 15 years, and at the age of 19, he was already the number two rated player in the world rating, second to only world champion Anatoly Karpov. And in the first match against Karpov, he was down 5-0 in the first to six wins match, and everyone predicted to lose 6-0, but Kasparov held his fighting spirit and managed to come back and get three wins. After 48 games, the match ended without result. Even both players wanted to continue. FIDE was concerned about the player's health, and the second match was organized when the players would play best of 24. And Kasparov won the match 13-11 and became world champion. Later on, these two had more matches. It was very close, but Kasparov always proved to be a little bit better in clutch situation. He was known for a very aggressive attacking style, best opening preparations of all time, and killer instinct. When he was playing, he wanted to kill his opponent, and it was the attitude of a great champion. He dominated the chess scene for 15 straight years, and he was the highest rated player in the world for 21 years. He also... he also won the chess Oscar for 11 times, and he dominated the chess scene for 21 to 25 years. There are a lot of stories about him, crazy stories. For example, he played a simultan against Hungarian national team. So he played at one time like 10 grandmasters, and he won against most of them. So probably every chess player would say that he's the best, although some say Bobby Fischer. I would like to know your opinions on your top 5 list. Maybe you have a different one, and also I would like to know if you would like from time to time me to make such a video like this one. So it's sort of like chess documentary, or you can call something like that. Yeah, please leave a comment, and bye bye guys.